the footprint of Nextlink has grown massively over the last few years. We put up, last year we put up 135 new towers. We're now 400 tower locations and close to 22,000 subscribers. It was probably 2 or 3 years ago we started putting towers kind of on top of towers, and then we had towers that we were started to co-locate with other ISPs. And so when our access points started to fill up, it was very difficult to put to overlay another access point because of the spectrum. It was either us or a competitor had eaten up most of the spectrum. So that's when we started looking for a different technology or different ways to mitigate the interference. And so we started putting up smaller towers in smaller areas, but our access points still started filling up. And so that's probably when 2 or 3 years ago when I went to WISP and saw the product there. So we got a couple of them and put them up on a tower and noticed really quick that, you know, it helped with the interference. And we said, okay, well, let's throw up a whole tower, a complete tower with them and see how it performs. And they performed really, really well. We put it on a tower that had another service provider on it and noticed that the interference almost went away completely. So we were pretty excited about the performance. And since then we've put them on pretty much every tower that we've had. So in the last couple of years, we've put up real close to 2,000 RF element antennas.
We were nervous about them at first because there was low gain, but after actually throwing them out in the field, that low gain, but being able to cut out some of that signal, was actually able to increase some of our link budget. So better modulation rates and actually better signal levels in a lot of scenarios that we've seen.
After introducing the RF elements, we saw a major decrease of just all spectrum related issues. The bleed through was gone. The true side-to-side interference, we didn't see it. So it was great there. It reduced our workload completely. At that time we had 3 personnel running 24/7. So to have that into our network was great.
Since we've transitioned to the horns, we've been able to really increase the amount of customer capacity on the access side with in terms of spectrum availability.
One of the benefits we've seen with the horns is, we got to a point where people were requiring more bandwidth, and we have to limit the amount of people that are on our APs. And with a horn, when we max out that limit, we're able to easily go up, throw a small antenna to feed, 10, 15, 20 people without overloading the tower.
The RF elements, we've got 12 access points on this tower. One side of the tower is getting really, really full with customers. So with RF elements, it allows us to throw up another access point. So in that particular area, now we've overlaid the tower 3 times in that one direction. So 12 original antennas plus 3 more antennas facing the same direction. And they're working perfectly.
The horns have helped us out a lot in that situation. Instead of just blurring out the signal with the sectors, we've been able to focus the signal more into the areas that we're trying to hit, instead of just throwing a bunch of noise out there and everybody interfering with it. Our competitors are also starting to go to horns too, so it's a win-win for everybody.
As far as our customer service, it has tremendously improved. We have been able to get a lot better clarity on getting interference out of there and making sure that we can get dedicated connections to those APs that we have. We can increase our customer base because we don't have to worry about so much saturation on the RF side.
We're now starting to offer 35 and 50 meg packages off of the same access points that we were offering, 10, 15, and 25 meg packages. So now we're offering 50 meg packages off basically the same platform, but because the RF elements antennas allow us to mitigate that noise, we can now offer those 50 meg packages.
We do 4 towers a week, probably 12 towers a month around there is the average. And that's 100 plus horns that we're getting done. And with the size of these and the efficiency of putting them on the pipes, it goes quickly and smoothly.
Whenever we backpack these ones up the tower, it's not a lot of weight. They're really light. I mean, really, when we go to mount it, there's not a whole lot you gotta do to mount it. You just put it up there and stuck the bolt right through, tightened it up, and we were good to go, you know.
When we deploy a tower, we'll run spectrum analysis on everything, find the cleanest channels, and we'll try to basically use an ABC configuration.
For our towers that have 12 APs on them, we'll use 12 RFE 40s. That way we get a little bit of overlap on each side so that it makes up for the human error as far as pointing them. With the 8 APs, we'll use RFE 50s. And then once we get the 6 APs, we usually stick with the 60s. We haven't really seen much of a gap in the APs with those. We are using the GPS sync on it. We use an ABC channel plan. Usually our opposite facing APs are on the same channel, and we've seen have pretty good results with that.
On our newer towers, we deploy the horns initially, and we've noticed that there's been a lot more consistent performance on the GPS synchronization, a lot less GPS frame loss. So our overall performance has been much better.
Just seeing all of that technology getting better, it just makes us better, you know, as a company too, to be able to deliver the best product that we can. And so from where we started to now is drastic change.
It was a perfect solution for us. And that's, at that point, we've kind of started, we don't put any other antennas up. It's all RF elements from here on out.